the center of Vienna might not look like the place to learn anything about European-Japanese relations, but actually it rather is. In the newly reopened Ethnographic Museum, now the World Museum, you can find what the Habsburgs collected, among other things, in Japan. And you can see how Japan presented itself during the World Fair in Vienna, just as it started opening. And when it started opening, it also had quite the effect on arts and artists in Europe. And now you can have a look at an exhibition in the Kunstforum, the Art Forum of the Bank Austria, in the center of Vienna as well, about the fascination of Japan. Of Japanism, of Japomanie, as it came into Europe quite strongly once Japan opened, switches very nicely back and forth between Japanese art, especially Japanese woodcut prints, ukiyo-e, and the paintings of European artists which were influenced by that. Among other things, we have some of the woodcut prints of the views of Mount Fuji. You should know The Wave, for example. But then also European artists look at, well, actually European women who dressed up a bit as Japanese. And as usual, the exotism gave quite some permission to change to a bit of a more open, one might even say exhibitionist view. There is a bit of money. And again, woodcut prints on the one hand, and on the other side, on the other hand, things like Gauguin, Degas, Van Gogh. One of the typical things, a perspective which changes to be different, to be flatter and yet give some depth. These two, such flyers, such leaflets or posters in this case, are quite well known, also become well known not just from Paris, but from Vienna after the secession, the secession, the Art Nouveau. And they are actually influenced very much by Japanese woodcut prints. Klimt. Once you know it, you can find it, you can see it. He too was a collector and was influenced. His woodcuts, well, the woodcuts he collected from Japan and his creations. Once you know it, you can find the collections. And there were people, this too is interesting, who were importing goods, art, everything from Japan and selling it. And the artists, which we know so much about, were quite the avid buyers of such things, difficult as they had it to judge the quality. And again, on the one side you have Japanese woodcuts, here it's more of the house scenes, and their influence. Including, one gets here to the Wiener Werkstätte, the Vienna Manufactory, where the black and white of kimono prints and then of other things that they produced is again something you can't unsee once you have seen, but it makes for a fascinating connection. Klimt again. Landscapes, including from Klee. And landscapes of Hokusai, bridges, and of the Tokaido by Hiroshige. Finally, towards the end, we get to some mystical, magical, and a bit horrific, and to animals, with some prints of monsters and some influence of theirs, as well as simply nature, including cat pictures.